Hoodies was created really out of the feminist movement that came out of the 1960s and the 1970s in response to the fact that there wasn't really a safe space for Latina women leaders to really engage with the community and take leadership roles in the kind of work and action that they wanted to see happen in the Chicagoland area.
I started about 17 years ago in our domestic violence program, and then I transitioned to other positions within the organization. We serve survivors of domestic violence and also their children who have been affected by domestic violence.
We also provide sexual assault counseling, therapy, as well as medical and legal advocacy. And so we do engage with hospital staff when they are receiving patients who have been victims of some type of sexual assault.
Mi nombre es Maricela Santillán, y más conocida como Maricela Guadarrama por mi esposo. Soy de México, de Celaya, Guanajuato, y tengo aquí como 28 años. Empecé yo a venir ya venía yo, pero yo ya traía como arrastrando algo desde tiempo, ¿no? Entonces, algo que en sí no me dejaba avanzar, entonces yo fui abusada.
Supervised visitation is something that we're really keen on serving because we're the only ones that in Chicago who provide it in Spanish. We do legal advocacy, so we go to the courts and we accompany our clients to seek orders of protection so that they're not alone and they understand the process that they are participating in.
We have our parent support program, which provides support to and guidance to parents who are, you know, feeling challenged by being in a new community and new society as a whole. That program offers that support and guidance for, you know, to strengthen families, really.
Empresarias del Futuro también me hizo entender o comprender que no toda la gente afuera son mis clientes, pero sí algunas personas van a gustar de mi producto o de mi servicio.
We also do a Latina entrepreneurship program that's called Empresarias del Futuro, where we also use a curriculum-based program where we educate women who have begun to start a new business or are about to start a business and are trying to think about what are the steps that they need to consider and then take if they want to launch their business.
Yo no tengo más que gratitud hacia Mujeres Latinas en Acción, sobre todo a esa persona que algún día se le ocurrió formar la organización. Y pues soy una de muchas mujeres que han sido beneficiadas con los programas.
When our participants come in, they're really looking for someone to really listen to them, for somebody to really help them understand and figure out the way to really make things better for themselves and their communities.
Antes pues mis hijas estaban en la escuela y una de mis hijas precisamente no aprendía. Yo la notaba que necesitaba algo, pero no sabía qué. Alguien me dijo, ve a Mujeres Latinas y ahí la van a ayudar.
We want to be able to expand to other areas where other Latinas are, but we wouldn't be able to do that without the support from funders and individual donors willing to commit to the work that we provide and continue the great work that once María Mangual started 45 years ago.
Gracias, Mujeres Latinas en Acción.